one is going off.
Since 1978, Metro Optics has proudly provided world-class eye care and eyewear right here in the Bronx. The eyes, often referred to as the windows to the soul, are also the windows to your overall health. Comprehensive eye examinations are a key component of overall personal health care, as they can reveal not only conditions and diseases of the eye, but also signs of other health issues, such as high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, autoimmune disease, and even certain cancers. This spring, two of the pioneers of hip-hop, Grandmaster Melly Mel and Grandmaster Caz, visited the flagship Metro Optics location in Throgs Neck for comprehensive eye examinations and new eyewear. Grandmaster Melly Mel selected a new Kazal frame and also a white Carrera, into which our in-house lab put transition lenses in his prescription. Caz chose a different Kazal frame with flash mirror lenses that'll really stand out on stage. He also chose a sophisticated brand new Gucci model for his reading glasses prescription.
You can't spell Kazal without Caz.
C-A-Z, baby.
That's the commercial.
That's the commercial.
I'm glad I thought of it.
There you go.
Good to see you.
You planned it out.
See? It's all good.
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 in the streets. In the race, in the train. Legacies, from what is all the killers on the hands. Legacies, from what is it? Like a sport, brand new. Sign up all, can. Man in the match like running. The job will go out to a plan. We can pull it, you brand new. All the killers on the stand. I got product in the man. Jesus got beat in the brand. Credit cards and scams. Beat in the list in the band. Legacy, from what is it? Like a plan. I'm blowing it like on my tongue. All the killers on the hands. Legacy, from what is it?
Very important of why I put it in here, because at the top of that phrase where you can see St. Mary's Projects, where I came from, and then you can understand that the Bronx and the arts and everything we're doing is going all the way up. But make some noise for yourself for being so beautiful tonight. Nah, y'all not giving yourself enough credit. Make some noise for yourself for being beautiful enough. Do y'all know where we at in New York City? Do you know where this location is at? Do y'all, like, y'all know what happens around that? The CEO of the party's in the Bronx right now, so much respect to Michael Dolan for being my partner. And understand it's not about paying people to hold drinks in their hand. We're not doing that no more. We're going to put on cultural events that can stimulate the people, the culture, and do things and graduate this thing. We got to have a graduation as a culture, and it's starting here with everybody in here tonight. And I'm from the Bronx, and I almost died on these streets. And to be able to come back in here and to put on this art fair and this music fair, and you don't have to pay nothing, and we can just enjoy and take something back and spread positive energy. God damn, I'm happy tonight.
Another stage, another night, stage destroyed. Melly Mel has left the building.
Snitch Glover, we out.
Can I?
Yeah.
Jin, I am a MC, right? I mean, definitely a student and fan of this hip hop thing, right? And I got into it at a very young age, I would say about 12, 13 years old. But what's beautiful is I remember starting out purely as a fan, and then the more I got kind of pulled into it, you know, picking up the mic, writing my own rhymes, and then even at like 15 years old, having a dream of becoming a rap star, right? Like as a kid, that's really how you think it. And yo, God bless me in a way that it kind of came true, right? I signed my first record deal when I was like 20 years old, was with a major label for a few years, Rough Riders actually, shout out to Double R, was with them for like 4 or 5 years. And then when I parted with them, kept doing music. And here I am now, like close to 15 years as far as doing this for a living. And at the end of the day, due to ups and downs in my career, I think the one thing that always remained constant, the older I get, the more I realize it, is, man, just how much I love hip hop. That's the only way I can describe it. I mean, my mom and dad, they're both from Hong Kong, and they, you know, them along with their family and their parents, they came to the US, like we're talking like the 70s, and just hardworking Chinese immigrants. I mean, in short, right? They ended up doing like what a lot of the Chinese immigrants at that time would embark on, which is like Chinese food, like a takeout restaurant. So I grew up in that. Now this could be part of why I started to develop kind of this idea of, man, I like interacting with people, performing, whether it's in front of a camera or not in front of a camera. Maybe being at that restaurant every day as a kid forced me to use my imagination, right? And I'm running around the restaurant, I'm trying to get everybody's attention. And then at that same time is when I made this connection with hip hop. And it was just a beautiful marriage. I remember the first song that really had me going nuts was LL's Mama Said Knock You Out.
All right, tonight, you're gonna be checking out some of the best, I repeat, the best B-boys, the best crews from across the US and Canada. Each of these eight teams that you're gonna see tonight, oh yeah, there's a chart for y'all.
All right.
We spent 4 hours making that, so look at it. I didn't spend 4 hours, but you know, we had some McDonald's staff that did. Each of these teams has won like major competitions all across the world. They all got their own style, and they are gonna throw down right here tonight. Y'all make some noise for them, y'all.
Let me tell you, the fate lies in the hands of these three judges.
Lifetime Achievement Award for my contribution to the art of hip hop dance, and I'm very honored because this particular B-boy competition raises money for Ronald McDonald Charities, and you know what, it's for families and for children. So just with that said, at the end of the day, we're making children and families happy, so I'm very honored to be here.
a legendary pioneer and still working artist, DJ Jazzy J still DJs and performs. He has worked in the business over 30 years and is still a respected artist. Breaking onto the scene in the late 70s, he has mentored some of the top DJs in the genre. DJ Jazzy J built relationships with everyone, including Rick Rubin, leading to the creation of Def Jam. He has been featured in documentaries, films, and TV specials recognizing his lifetime of musical achievement. A father, husband, and teacher, Jazzy J continues to this day to influence the genre he helped create. DJ Jazzy J. Tats Crew is an illustrious art collective with roots firmly planted in graffiti and urban art. Nicer, BG183, and Bio are Bronx legends who have transformed the world of art and lived their own artistic expression. Tats Crew is a group of New York City-based professional muralists whose work in aerosol has transformed graffiti into a commercially beneficial art form. Nonprofit work has and will continue to be a large part of the community work Tats Crew does to maintain the social responsibility of their business. They have lectured at many colleges and at community-based organizations. Tats Crew.
Deborah Harris is an enterprising woman of color who looked at the tour market and recognized a unique entree. Hip-hop wasn't represented. Teaming with hip-hop luminaries like Grandmaster Caz, she offered the first tour focusing on a hip-hop culture. Now today, many visitors from all over the globe have been introduced to real hip-hop and learned the true foundations of this beautiful art form with the Hush Tours. Deborah Harris, Hush Tours. TT Torres is the music director and multimedia personality for the lead station in New York City, Hot 97. Not only an exclusive media source in her own right, TT also formats the music at the top station in New York City. Hardworking and dynamic, TT Torres has been featured in various media outlets including The Source, Star, and Vibe magazines. TT Torres is an activist for women empowerment. She joined the efforts of the Saving Our Cinderellas on Broadway program, supporting and mentoring young girls at St. Luke's School in the Bronx. These youths are extremely interested in the musical theater arts world, and her involvement supports their dreams. TT Torres.
You're here with the two Grandmasters. I'm Grandmaster Melly Mel.
And I'm Grandmaster Caz.
And we represent Windows of Hip Hop, and we want you to join us in our campaign to do a hip hop campus right here in the Bronx.
And we had the privilege and the honor of having Windows of Hip Hop come and visit us. Definitely, it's part of our culture and the children's culture. And having them come made them feel special. It made them feel like they had hope. And it motivated so many of them.
Well, the kids love it because of the simple fact, adding music into the educational process, it makes it easier for them to actually understand and gravitate toward learning.
Make it on a, come on, don't push me,
cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head.
And we all want y'all to be on Team Windows of Hip Hop. Grandmaster Melly Mel.
Grandmaster Caz, support us, baby.
And you.